Yeah.
Oh, I forgot I don't have a mouse. What do I need to do? Oh, that's what I need to do. Yeah, I guess it's time to start. Make sure everything's up. Alright. May have just ran out today. I think you were gifted your last one. Let me see the activity feed. No, you resubbed 19 days ago. What up? Maybe... Don't know. Weird. Why am I mouse in the middle of the screen though? Go away. I just realized I'm kind of dumb. Everything else should be fine for now. Okay, yeah, it's all fine. Let's get it started. Yeah, that should do. Do you remember what I chose for Persona 3? I think it was normal, though. We'll just keep it baseline. Because honestly, I would do it. I'd do it on hard, but I want to keep it baseline for streaming. I did beat the game on hard before, so I'll take it. Game looks great. Nice.
Ah, it seems we have a guest with an intriguing destiny. My name is Eagle. I am delighted to make your acquaintance. This place exists between dream and reality, mind and matter. It is a room that only those who are bound by a contract may enter. It may be that such a fate awaits you in the near future. Now then, why don't you introduce yourself?
Oh, my last name. I'm having a moment. As you can see.
I see. Now, let's take a look into your future, shall we? Do you believe in fortune telling? Each reading is done with the same cards, yet the result is always different. Life itself follows the same principles, doesn't it? The tower in the upright position represents the immediate future. It seems a terrible catastrophe is imminent. The card indicating the future beyond that is... the moon in the upright position. This card represents hesitation and mystery. Very interesting indeed. It seems you will encounter a misfortune at your destination, and a great mystery will be imposed upon you. In the coming days, you will enter into a contract of some sort, after which you will return here. The coming year is a turning point in your destiny. If the mystery goes unsolved, your future may be forever lost. My duty is to provide assistance to our guests to ensure that does not happen. Ah, I have neglected to introduce my assistant to you. This is Margaret. She is a resident of this place, like myself.
My name is Margaret. I am here to accompany you through your journey.
We shall attend to the details another time. Until then, farewell.
Yeah, buddy.
Politicians?
Isn't it just stuff like money and connections? When you get down to it, financial and political clouds will matter.
supposed to mean?
Well, what do you think?
Well, I'm sure that you all know already, but at the end of this month, he will be transferring to another school. Quiet down, guys. I'm not done yet. Just about.
Everyone's mind has had this love triangle with them. Dojima. I'll be looking after you. Let's see, I'm your mother's younger brother, and that about sums it up. I'll say, you've really grown. I still remember when you were in diapers. This here's my daughter. Come on, Nanako. Introduce yourself to your cousin.
Hello.
What are you so shy for?
I just have the, Hi, I'm Daisy thing in my head.
You dropped this. Whatever. All I did was pick it up.
What's wrong?
God, I hate her. This looks really good. Alright, that did not look good, never mind.
Hi. Welcome to Mole.
Can you go to the bathroom by yourself?
Uh-huh. It's in the back, to your left. You know which way's left? The side you don't hold your chopsticks in.
I know. Jeez.
Are you taking a trip?
No, we just went to pick him up. He just moved here from the big city.
The city, huh?
Fill up my car while you're at it. Regular's fine.
Right away, sir.
No time's any for a smoke.
Are you in high school? Does it surprise a city boy to see how little there is out here? There's so little to do, I'm sure you'll get bored fast. You'll either be hanging out with your friends or doing part-time jobs. Speaking of which, we're actually looking for part-time help right now. Give it some thought, why don't you? We don't mind if you're a student. Oh, I should get back to work.
understandable. It must have been a long trip for you. Why not take a little walk? Get some fresh air. Just let me know when you're ready to go. Mom and Dad are busy as always. They're working overseas, was it? I know it's only for a year, but getting stuck in a place like this because of your parents? It's rough being a kid. Well, it's just me and Nanako here, so it'd be nice having someone like you around. So long as you're here, you're part of the family. So make yourself at home. Come on, there's no need to be so formal. Look, you're making Nanako all tense. Well, anyway, let's eat. Oh, who's calling at this hour? Kojima speaking.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? We'll see. So where is it? All right, I'm on my way. Looks like I made the right choice to skip the booze. Sorry, but I gotta go take care of some business. Go ahead and eat without me. I don't know how late I'll be. Nanako, you help him out, okay?
Okay.
Nanako, it's raining out. What did you do with the laundry?
I already brought it in.
All right. Well, I'm off.
I like the little sound effects that they did.
iTelevision has decided to cancel all of announcer Mayumi Yamano's televised appearances. Until allegations of an affair with Mr. Namatame are resolved, she'll remain off the air and out of the public eye.
This is boring.
At Juness, every day is Customer Appreciation Day. Come see for yourself and get in touch with our products. Every day's great at your Juness.
Every day's great at your Juness. Aren't you going to eat?
breakfast ready. Good morning. Okay, let's eat. There was some kind of trouble. You won't be back. You're starting school today, right? My school's on the way, so let's go together. You keep going straight from here. My school's this way. Bye!
Talk about bad luck. The homeroom teacher here is Morioka, isn't it?
Yeah, it's King Moron, all right. We get to enjoy his long-ass sermons every day for a whole year.
Hey, you guys, I heard there's going to be a transfer student from the city in this class.
Huh? Really? A guy or a girl?
A transfer student from the city? Just like you, huh, Yosuke? Huh? You look dead today.
Yeah, I don't want to talk about it.
What's with him? Who knows?
All right, shut your traps. I'm Kinshiro Morioka, your homeroom teacher from today forward. First things first. Just because it's spring doesn't mean you can swoon over each other like love-struck baboons. Long as I'm around, you students are gonna be pure as the driven snow. Now, I hate wasting my time, but I'd better introduce this transfer student. This sad sack's been thrown from the big city out to the middle of nowhere like yesterday's garbage. And he's just as much of a loser here as he was there. So you girls better not get any ideas about hitting on him. Tell him your name, kid, and make it quick. What's that look you're giving that girl back there by the window? You thought I wouldn't notice? Now listen up! This town is miles away from your big city of perverts and assholes in more ways than one. You'd better not even think of getting involved with the girls here. Let alone abusing them. But what do I know? It's not like the old days. Even here, kids grow up so damn fast. Every time I turn my back, you're fooling around on those damn phones, checking your life journals and your my places.
Excuse me, is it okay if the transfer student sits here?
Huh? Yeah, sure. You hear that? Your seat's over there. So hurry up and sit down already.
He's the worst, huh? Rotten luck for you to get stuck in this class. Well, we just have to hang in there for a year.
Yummy lag.
Sucks to be the transfer student, ending up in King Moron's class on the first morning here.
Yeah, he won't think twice about suspending you if you get on his bad side. Then again, we're all in the same boat.
Shut your traps! I'm taking roll. I damn well expect you to respond in an orderly manner. That's all for today. Normal lectures will start tomorrow.
Attention all teachers. Please report immediately to the faculty office for a brief staff meeting. All students must return to their classrooms and are not to leave the school until further notice.
Duh. You heard the announcement. Don't go anywhere until you hear otherwise.
He's seriously getting on my nerves.
I can already tell there's just going to be lag in some parts like that.
Don't those sirens sound really close?
I can't see a damn thing. Freaking fog.
Yeah, like every time it rains lately, it gets all foggy.
Hey, did you hear? I hear that paparazzi looking all the way over for that announcer.
Oh, yeah. You mean Mayumi Yamano, right? I heard some guy spotted her at the shopping district.
Actually, I heard that.
Are you serious? Hey, Yukiko-san. Mind if I ask you something? Is it true that announcer's staying at your family's inn?
I can't discuss such things.
Yeah, I guess not.
Sheesh. How much longer is this gonna take?
There's no telling.
I should've left before the announcement came on. By the way, did you try what I told you the other day? You know, that thing about rainy night?
Oh. No, not yet. Sorry.
That's okay. It's just, I heard a guy in the class next door yell something like, "My soulmate is Yamano, the announcer."
Attention, all students. There has been an incident inside the school district. Police officers have been dispatched around the school zone. Please stay calm and contact your parents or guardians as soon as possible and quickly leave the school grounds. Do not disturb the police officers. Head directly home. I repeat.
Incident?
What? Something actually happened?
Come on, let's go take a look.
Satanaka, this was really awesome. Like, the way he moved was just amazing to see. And I'm really sorry, it was an accident. Please just have mercy until my next paycheck. See ya, thanks!
Stop right there! What did you do to my DVD?
Are you worried about me?
He's fine, Yukiko. Let's ditch him and go home.
You're Yuki, right? You want to go hang out somewhere?
What? Who are you?
What's up with him? What school's he from?
Never mind that. He's going for Yukiko-san? Man, you'd think he'd at least wait until she's alone to make his move.
I bet you a can of Tappy gets knocked out.
No bet. Haven't you heard how difficult the Amagi challenge is?
So are you coming or not?
I'm not going.
Fine!
What did he want from me?
What did he want? Obviously he was asking you out on a date.
Huh? Really?
You really had no
then again, that was way over the top. It was creepy how he called you Yuki all of a sudden.
Yo, Yukiko-san. Turned down another lovelorn fool, huh? Man, you're cruel. You got me the same way last year.
I don't recall doing that.
Oh, are you serious? So then you want to hang out sometime?
I'd rather not.
That'll teach me to get my hopes up. Anyways, you two better not pick on the transfer student too much.
We're just curious is all.
I'm sorry for dragging you into this.
Come on, let's go. Everyone's staring.
So you came here because of your parents' job? I thought it was something way more serious. There really is nothing here, huh? That's what makes it nice. But there is nothing much we can show to people from outside. Though there is something from Mount Yasagami. I think our dyed clothes or pottery or something is kind of famous. Oh, wait! And there's the Amagi Inn! Yukiko's family runs it. It's the pride of Inaba.
Huh? It's just an old inn.
No way! It's been in all sorts of magazines as a hidden treasure! It's a great inn. It's been going for generations, and Yukiko here is gonna take over someday. Their inn actually attracts a lot of visitors to Inaba. It pretty much keeps this town going.
I don't think that's entirely true.
So, tell me. You think Yukiko's cute, huh? Oh, I knew it!
Come on, don't start this again.
She's really popular at school, but she's never had a boyfriend. Kinda weird, huh?
Come on, stop it. You shouldn't believe that, okay? It's not true that I'm popular or that I've never had a boyfriend. Wait, no. What I meant to say was I don't need a boyfriend. Jeez, Chie.
Sorry, I'm sorry. But this is our chance to talk to someone from the big city. And you barely said a word. Hey, what's that?
So that high schooler left school early, and as she came down this street...
Wow, who could imagine that hanging from an antenna?
I wanted to see it too.
Oh, you got here too late. The police and fire department took it down just a moment ago.
Well, I think it's terrifying. I can't believe a dead body showed up around here.
Wait, what did she just say? A dead body?
What are you doing here? Huh. I should have figured that had happened. That damn principal. We told him not to let them through here.
You know this guy?
I'm Detective Dojima, his guardian. Well, how should I say this? I hope you get along with him. But you three really ought to stop wandering around and head straight home.
It's him.
Adachi, how long are you going to act like a rookie? You want to be sent back to the central office?
I'm sorry.
Go wash your face. I'm going to go around and gather information.
Was this what that announcement was about?
What do they mean? It was hanging from the antenna.
Hey, Yukiko. Why don't we go to Juness some other time?
Good idea.
All right, then. We're taking off. Starting tomorrow, neighbor, let's do our best.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see if I can fix the, put it to 150. I want to see how it looks. It looks a little better. Okay.
Again tonight.
Our top story this evening concerns a bizarre case in a quiet suburb. Around noon today, a woman was found dead near the Samegawa River in Inaba. The deceased has been identified as Miss Mayumi Yamano, a 27-year-old announcer at the local television station. The initial results of the Inaba Police Department's investigation have revealed...
The Inaba Police Department. That's where Dad works. It's his job, so things like this happen.
The body was found hanging from a large television antenna atop a local resident's roof. Authorities are uncertain as to why the body was in such a state. With the cause of death also uncertain, police continue to investigate whether the death is an accident or a homicide. A thick fog common to the area has slowed their progress, and plans to fully canvass the area are delayed until tomorrow.
They found her on the roof? That's scary. It's Juness.
At Juness, every day is Customer Appreciation Day. Come see for yourself and get in touch with our products.
Every day's great at your Juness.
Every day's great at your Juness. You memorized it already? I'm the best one in my class.
You saved me. Thanks. Oh yeah, that's right. You're that transfer student. I'm Yosuke Hanamura. Nice to meet you. Oh yeah, I'm fine. Say, did you hear about the incident from yesterday? They found that announcer lady hanging from an antenna. You think it was some kind of warning? There's no way something that weird could have been an accident. Dangling a dead body over a roof like that? That's just messed up. Then again, it's pretty messed up to kill someone in the first place. Oh crap, we're late. You want a ride? It's a little squeaky, but it should be fine.
Yeah, whenever I click off the window, it does something stupid, so.
So, you getting used to this place? Wow, that was fast. There isn't much to do here compared to the big city. But there is that certain something you can't get anywhere else. The air is clean, the food's great. Oh, you know about the local delicacy? It's grilled steak, man. Like that's anything special, huh? I know a place where you can get it cheap. Wanna come? You help me.
What about me, huh? No apologies?
My trial of the dragon?
You always come around when I'm talking about food.
How about it, Yukiko? Don't you think he should treat us too?
I'll pass. I don't want to gain any more weight. I need to help out at the inn today anyway.
Wow, Yukiko-san. You started training to take over the business?
It's not like that. I'm just helping out when it gets busy. Well, I should be on my way.
Oh well, we should get going too.
Huh? Do I seriously have to treat two people?
This is the cheap place you were talking about? Ugh, they don't have grilled steak here.
Yeah, well, once you hopped on the freeloader train, I had to change my plans.
Still, that's no reason to take us to your place.
Dude, this isn't my place or anything. Oh, right. I haven't told you yet, huh? I moved here from another city about 6 months back. This location just opened up and my dad was assigned to manage it. So our entire family came out here. Here, this is to welcome you to town. Sadanaka, yours is on me too.
Yeah, I know. It's only been half a year since this place opened up, but I haven't been to the local shopping district much since. A lot of stores there started closing, and...
Can't blame it all on Jeunesse, can you?
Hello.
Hey, it's Saki-senpai. Sorry, be right back.
That's Saki Kanishi. Her family runs a liquor store in the shopping district. I think she's working here part-time.
Hey, how's it going? You look beat.
Hey, I'm finally on break. What's up, Hana-chan? Boosting the family business by bringing your friends here?
Oh, madam, you ruined me.
Kidding aside, you look down. Did something happen?
Oh, it's nothing. I'm just a little tired.
Hey, if you need to talk, I'm always willing to listen. I...
I'm okay. Thanks, though. Why did I leave school early yesterday? Hey! Is he the kid who transferred here? Are you the transfer student? Oh, did you hear about me already? It must be nice to have someone else from the big city to talk to, huh? I don't see Hana-chan hanging out with the other guys much.
Not necessarily.
He doesn't have too many friends. So I hope you two get along good. Hana-chan's a good guy, but he can get nosy sometimes. You gotta tell him right to his face when he starts to annoy you. I know. I'm just kidding.
Come on, Senpai. There's no need to worry about something like that.
Well, my break's just about over. Back to work I go. Laters.
Oh, Senpai? Saki-senpai says I'm annoying, but she's even nosier than me. She has a younger brother, and she treats me pretty much the same way.
Oh, you don't want her treating you like a brother, huh? I get it. So that's how it is. The daughter of a local family-run liquor store, and the scion of the invading chain. Oh, the flame of forbidden love.
Dude, it's not like that.
Really? Well, I know just the thing to cheer up that lovesick heart. You ever hear of the Midnight Channel? You're supposed to look into a TV that's switched off, alone, exactly at midnight on a rainy night. While you're staring at your own image, another person will appear on the screen. And they say that person's your soulmate.
What? For a second, I thought you were actually going to say something useful. How can you get all excited over such a childish urban legend like that?
Childish, huh? You don't believe it, do you?
Of course I don't.
Well, it's raining tonight. Let's all try it out. Then you'll see.
Try it out? Wait, you haven't even tried it yourself? Wow. I'm trying to remember the last time I heard something this stupid. All that aside, you know that incident yesterday? You guys think it was murder? Ooh, what if the culprit behind it was still lurking around?
Sheesh. You shouldn't joke about stuff like that. Now who's the childish one? All I'm saying is, you guys better try it out tonight.
No. He always says he will.
What a day. I'm back. Did anything happen while I was out?
No. You're late again.
I'm sorry. I'm busy at work. Can you put the news on for me?
Next, more details in the developing story on the incident in Foggy Inaba. Announcer Mayumi Yamano's dead body was found hanging above a house in this isolated rural town. It is confirmed that Miss Yamano had been involved in an affair with Taro Namatame, husband of Enka singer Misuzu Hiragi. Police plan to investigate this relationship and question any personnel involved with them. In addition, we now bring you an exclusive interview with the local student who found Miss Yamano's body.
An interview with a kid? Where the hell did they find her?
What went through your mind when you saw it? Could you tell she was dead? Did you see her face? Don't you think it's scary that someone was killed on a foggy day?
Huh? She was killed?
So, did you see anyone suspicious around here?
No, not really.
We heard that you found it when you left school early. Did you have some personal business to take care of?
Huh? That's...
A tragedy that occurred near the local shopping district. Many store owners are raising concerns about losing customers as a result.
If they lose more customers, it'll be because you're making such a stink about it.
It really is a bizarre case, isn't it? I mean, hanging someone upside down from an antenna, I'd have to say it's a warning or a sign from the culprit.
Yes, but so far, no one has come forward to take credit for the crime.
Loads of prank calls, though.
It's fun. So it's all stories. Me, honestly. Everything's fine. I'm just doing story at the moment. There's nothing really going on. The only other thing I have to figure out is to stop the lag moments. I also have to learn to not skip through everything, even though I've read everything like 5 times. Open the door. You got that touchscreen TV. This is the one downside to this game, is just story for like 2 hours.
Sorry.
I don't want to look up answers yet. Before AD? Probably zero AD. No? Where's my phone? Oh.
Mimicking an execution? It's messed up. My senpai told me it was a third year named Saki who found the body.
Yo. It's, it's not really that important, but, well, yesterday on TV, she looked so down. She doesn't seem to be at school today either.
Huh? Hey, Yukiko, are you helping out at the inn today too?
Things are really out of hand right now. I'm sorry.
Hey, I think that's the same person I saw. I couldn't make out that much detail, though. The image I saw was much blurrier.
Wait, so you saw it too? And we saw the same girl? Does that mean we have the same soulmate?
How should I know? How about you? Did you see it? TVs are definitely in these days. Want to go check them out on the way back? We're beefing up our electronics department this month.
Oh, definitely. My parents don't know anything about electronics, and I just gotta see my kung fu movies on the big screen!
We've got some pretty big ones in stock. I bet they'd be big enough for you to fit into. Folks, honestly, not many people shop for TVs here. That's why we don't have clerks around.
Huh, not worth trying then, I guess. Well, at least look at screen.
Nope, can't get in. Figures.
This proves it. It was all just a dream.
Besides, these flat-screen TVs are so thin, you just end up on the other side. What am I saying? So, Chia, what kind of TV are you guys in the market for?
They said they wanted one that's cheap. You got any suggestions?
Well, miss, might I suggest this one over here? It's the newest model, just released this spring.
I should have asked what you meant by cheap right off the bat.
You got connections, right? Come on, hook me up!
No, we can't do that. Hey, how about this one over here? It's a display unit. It's a little old, but... Oh, yeah. What kind of TV do you...
Huh? Something wrong, Yosuke?
Is his arm in the TV?
Whoa. Is that some kind of new model? Like with a new function?
Hell no!
You gotta be kidding me! Did you really stick your hand through the screen?
Oh man, this is for real. That's some magic trick, man. So how's it work, huh? What's the magician's secret? Spacious.
I mean, what's going on?
Old crap. I think this is all too much for my bladder.
What the? Are you gonna pee your pants?
I've been holding it in all day. I haven't had a chance to go. I can't hold it anymore.
Which way did we come in from? I don't see a way in or out.
What? That can't be right. How could that be?
I don't know. Where is me? I can't take this anymore. I want to go home.
Okay, so how? Somehow.
That's true.
If there's no exit, we're trapped, so let's cross our fingers and look around.
What is this place? It feels different from where we were before.
It looks like we're in some kind of building, but damn, this fog's so thick I can hardly see.
Are you sure we're not wandering farther away?
I can't be positive, but we've gotta trust our instinct a little.
I know, but...
Hey, is it me or is the fog lighter here? No service. Surprise.
Can you guys slow down a little? It's hard enough to see where you're going. Huh? What the? It's a dead end. There's no exit.
Keeps getting creepier and creepier the further we go. Chair and rope? That kind of arrangement is never good. It's tied in a noose. Is this a scarf?
Come on! Let's go back to where we came from and look somewhere else for an exit.
Hey, I think I've seen that poster before. Seriously, starting to feel sick.
Phew! We finally made it back here. Wait, what's that?
There's something over there.
What is this thing? Monkey?
Attention shoppers! Our daily limited time sale will now begin at the side dish area on the first floor. Why not try the delicious fresh produce Juness picked for you this morning as your side dish for dinner tonight? All ages are invited to take advantage of this incredible bargain.
Crap, it's already that late?
Looks like we were in there for quite a while.
That's right. Now I remember where I saw that poster before. Look over there. That's the poster we saw.
What's up now? Hey, you're right. They're the same. I couldn't tell before without the face, but it was Misuzu Hiragi. She's been all over the news lately. Something about her husband having an affair with that announcer lady who died the other day.
Hey, so does that mean that weird room we saw? Could it be related to that Yamano lady's death? Now that I think about it, there was that creepy noose hanging from the ceiling. Ah, stop! No more! We gotta stop talking about this. I'm gonna wipe what happened today from my brain. I don't think my poor heart can take any more.
I'm feeling a chill, too. Let's go home. I want to lie down and rest.
Hey, welcome home. I doubt you'd know, but have you heard anything about a student named Saki Konishi? Oh, I see. Well, to be honest, we got a call from her family. She's disappeared. We've got people looking for her, but she hasn't been found yet. Work just keeps piling up.
And now, more on the case still casting a shadow over the foggy town of Inaba. Not long ago, television announcer Mayumi Yamano was found dead in the small town. Up until now, her whereabouts prior to her death had been unknown. But the police investigation has found that she had been staying in the region's famous Amagi Inn. She had apparently been staying there alone. Perhaps she was taking a vacation to recover from her ordeal?
Oh yes, the Amagi Inn. Their hot springs are first rate. The manager's teenage daughter also works there, and it's rumored that she'll take over the inn this spring. If that
I see. Moving along, it's time for the weather report. The rain has begun to subside. From now until morning, heavy fog warnings will be in effect in the Inaba region. Visibility will be severely reduced, so please be careful if you plan on driving in the area.
Is the ramen ready now?
Give it some more time. Are you sick? You're probably still adjusting to the new environment. Nanako, could you get him some cold medicine? You should get to bed after you take it.
You know what I forgot to do? Mature content warning.
Dad has to go do something. We got a call, so he left.
When I looked, I saw three police cars zooming.
for real? I don't know, but it seems like a lot of people have seen it. Yukiko said she'd be here after lunch. I wonder why they're holding a school assembly all of a sudden. Hey, what's wrong, Yosuke?
Oh, it's nothing.
Everyone, please, settle down. The school assembly is about to begin. First, the principal has something to say.
I regret to say that I have a terrible announcement for all of you. One of our third-year students, Ms. Saki Kunishi of Class 3, has passed away.
Passed away?
Ms. Kunishi was found deceased early this morning. The reasons behind her passing are currently under investigation by the police. If they ask you for your cooperation, I urge you, as students of this school, to provide only the facts. All right, please quiet down. I have been assured by the faculty that there's been no evidence that bullying was involved in the incident. So mind what you say, not only to the police, but to anyone who asks.
Found dead? How could this happen? She died the same way as that announcer, right? So creepy. Well, last time it was from an antenna, but this time she was hanging from a telephone pole. It's gotta be a serial murder case. Someone said the cause of death was some unknown poison. Unknown? Come on, this isn't some sci-fi drama. Oh, by the way, did you hear? Someone saw a girl that looked like Saki on that midnight channel thingy. They said she totally looked like she was in pain. Isn't that scary? Sounds like someone had a nightmare. Broadcasting their interviews with her non-stop, so maybe they just had Saki on the brain. Shh, it's easy to toss around theories if you're not personally involved.
Hey, did you guys check out the TV last night?
Yosuke, not you too!
Just listen for a second. Something kept bothering me, so I watched it again, and I think the girl in the school sucks. There's no mistaking it. Senpai looked like she was writhing in pain, and then she disappeared from the screen.
What?
You heard Senpai's body was found in a similar situation as that announcer's, right? Well, remember that guy you told us about? How he was all excited that his soulmate was the announcer? Maybe, just maybe, but Ms. Yamano might have been on that midnight channel before she died too.
What's that supposed to mean? Hold on. Are you saying people who appear on that TV die?
I can't say for sure. But something tells me. I just can't dismiss it as coincidence. Remember what that bear thing said? How that place was dangerous and we should leave before the fog clears? It also said that someone's been throwing people in there. And that room with the posters on the wall, it has to have something to do with the announcer's death. I mean, don't you think there's some kind of connection there? Couldn't that world in the TV have something to do with Senpai and the announcer's death? Well, what do you think? So it's not just me, huh? If there is a connection, then it's a good bet that the two of them went inside that world. That would explain the posters in that room. Which means, if we look around, we might find a place that has something to do with Senpai, too.
Yosuke, don't tell me.
Yeah, I'm thinking about going in again. I want to find out for myself.
Don't do this. You should just let the police handle this and...
You think we can rely on the police? They haven't made any progress on the announcer's case. Besides, even if we told them about the world inside the TV, there's no way they're gonna believe us. If I'm completely off base with this, that's fine. It's just, I need to know why Senpai had to die like this.
Yosuke.
After what I've seen and what I've put together, there's no way I can ignore it now. Sorry, but you're the only person who can help me. I'm gonna go get ready. I'll be waiting for you at Juness.
I can kinda understand how he feels. But we can't be sure we'll be able to get out safely again. What should we do? Are you serious? Anyways, let's go to Juness. We can't leave Yosuke alone.
It's nice it gives you the option to save there.
You guys came.
We came to stop you, idiots! Come on, you really shouldn't do this. It's too dangerous.
I know. We were able to come back once, right? If we go in from the same location, maybe we'll meet that bear again.
Maybe isn't good enough.
Look, I can't just act like everyone else and pretend this has nothing to do with it. What about you? Could you just walk away? Yeah, it'll be just you and me. Don't worry, I'm not going in without a plan. Chie, I'm leaving you in charge of this.
Huh? What's that? A rope?
We'll go in with this tied to me. So I want you to hold on to this and wait here. This is for you. I thought it might be better than going in empty-handed. All right, let's go. There's no use wasting any more time. Chie, whatever you do, don't let go of the rope.
Hey! I said wait!
It seems you will encounter a misfortune at your destination, and a great mystery will be imposed upon you.
You're the only ones I can ask. Will you promise me? Thank you!
Damn bear. Practically holding a gun to our heads. But it's true that we came here to figure things out. So far, we're completely in the dark. Look for the culprit, huh? Bring it on. You got my word, too. Might as well introduce ourselves. I'm Yosuke Hanamura, and this is my buddy. You got a name?
Teddy!
Figures. But how are we supposed to find the culprit in the first place?
I don't know. Oh, but I know where the last person came in.
The last person? You mean Saki-senpai?
I mean the person who came in and disappeared last time. I don't know the name. Take you there. You might find clues. Oh, one thing first. You two should put these on.
What are these glasses for? Whoa! The difference is like night and day. With these on, it's like the fog doesn't exist.
They'll help you walk through the fog. Well, I've been here for a long time. So you can rely on me. But I can only show you where the place is. You guys will have to defend yourselves.
What happened to relying on you? There better not be any monsters, you understand? We brought weapons, but, I mean, they're more for show. We just got here. If it's so dangerous, why don't you do something instead of relying on us?
Uh-uh. No way. I've got no muscles. Oh, I'll give you guys moral support from a safe distance. How's that sound?
For real? This is so lame. We swore to find the culprit, and this is all the backup we get?
Oh, yeah. Can I ask you something? Who's this Saki-senpai person? Someone you know?
That doesn't matter right now. Anyways, at least now we know Senpai might have been thrown in here. Maybe we can find more information, too. Let's get moving. This place. It looks just like the shopping district. What's going on here?
Some weird places have appeared here recently. Things are getting so tangled, I don't know what to do.
By the way, why are you standing so far from us? You better not be planning to hightail it if something does come up.
Of course not. I mean, I can't stand too close, you know? I get in your way.
Man, they really went all out on this. But out of all the places in town, why'd they replicate this one?
How should I know? This is reality for the one who's here.
As usual, nothing you say makes any sense. But if this is our shopping district, we're not far from Saki-senpai's. I knew it! This is the liquor store that Senpai's parents run. Does this mean Senpai disappeared here? What could have happened?
Wait a second! They're here!
What?
Shadows! I had a feeling they were going to attack.
Huh?
chance and take advantage of it, the battle will be a lot easier. I can tell this one has a weakness too. Try stuff out and see what works.
It's at very random parts it drops.
I'll keep track of what attacks have what effects on enemies.
There we go. It does it very randomly, but not very frequently.
Whoa, what was that? Did I hear you say persona? What was it? I mean, what did you do? Hey, you think I can do it too? Calm down, Yosuke. You're troubling Sensei. Sensei? Gosh almighty! You're amazing, Sensei! I can't believe you were hiding such an amazing power. No wonder the shadows were scared of you. Are you the one who's able to bring people into this world? That's what I thought. This is really something. Don't you think so, Yosuke?
If I click off the game, it pauses the game, which is really weird, so give me a sec. Right now... Steam is the only other thing that's taking up a lot. Otherwise, it's fine.
Dude, you call him Sensei and then don't show me any respect? Sorry.
I do not have another monitor.
Well, your support wasn't bad, though. I gotta give you some credit for that.
Huh? Really?
You two keep it up, and I think we'll be fine from here on out. Now let's get back to the investigation.
It is very much an L moment. I won't lie.
I wonder what could have happened to Senpai here.
I wish Jeunesse would go under. It's all because of that storm.
What the?
I heard that Konishi-san's daughter is working there.
You with your family's business suffering like it is.
I heard their sales have gone downhill because of Juness.
Stop it.
That poor father, to have his own daughter working for the enemy.
What a troublesome child.
Hey, Ted. You said that this place is reality for those that are here, right? So, does that mean this was Senpai's reality when she wandered in here?
I only know about what's over here.
Fine. Whatever's going on here, we'll find out ourselves. Damn it, not again.
Saki, how many times do I have to tell you?
Is this Senpai's dad?
You know what the neighbors say about you, right? Aren't you ashamed of yourself? You're the eldest daughter of a family who's owned this store for generations. Is it the money? Or did you meet some guy there? Just tell me why you have to work there of all places.
I can't believe this. She seemed like she had fun at work. She never said anything like this to me. You're telling me this was how Senpai really saw things? These photos. Hey, is this... took the other day with the other part-timers at Juness. Why is it cut up like this?
I never had the chance to say it.
Is that Senpai's voice?
I always...
Did it just lag or was it my connection? That is the game.
Huh?
Daddy was a real pain in the ass. I was nice to him just because he was the store manager's son. That's all. Takes it completely the wrong way and gets all enthusiastic. What a dick.
Pain in the ass?
Who cares about
Juness, anyway?
Because of that store, our business is ruined. My parents hate me. The neighbors talk behind my back. I wish everything would just disappear.
It's a lie. This can't be. Senpai's not like that. It's so sad. I feel so sorry for myself. Boo-hoo. Actually, I'm the one who thinks everything's a pain in the ass. Huh? Two Yosuke's? Who are you?
Yeah, like right there, it just lagged. How long am I going to be streaming? Probably not even another half hour, to be honest. The next time I play, you could probably see what I'm talking about a little bit more. Today I'm just doing all the, tutorial stuff, so I don't have to worry about it. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna be streaming this again. I'll just, tag you when I do. Probably be at night.
That's it? Boring.
Goodbye. Get home safe.
Sona.
Yeah, like it's doing it right now. It's very random when it does it. At first I thought it was just too much going on at once, so it's like trying to catch up. But now it's just that random.
So ashamed that I didn't want to report it. You're me. And I'm you. When we get down to it, all of this is me. Heard Senpai's voice. I wonder if that was something Senpai had been keeping deep down inside. He was a real pain in the ass, huh? What a way to find out. Jeez, this is so embarrassing. If you weren't here, I don't know what would have happened. Thanks. Hey, Teddy, could Senpai have been attacked by her other self here? Like how it just happened to me?
I think so. The shadows here were originally born from humans. Sometimes the fog clears, then they all go berserk. And you saw what happens next. A strong-willed shadow draws others to it, and the big mass of shadows kills the host.
So that's why people die when it gets foggy in our world.
Yosuke's pretty worn out. This world isn't made for humans. It's not comfortable for you here. I don't hear any more voices. I think we're done with this place. Let's go back.
Hey, Teddy. You said that this place is reality for people who enter, right? So that shopping district and the weird room we saw before, did they exist because the ones who died entered this world and it became their reality? I guess what I'm trying to ask is, did those places form because of the people who entered this world?
I don't know. It's never happened before, but that's probably where they were when the shadows attacked them. The fog does lift here sometimes. The shadows get really violent then. I always get so scared I have to hide when it happens. I sensed people here twice before. Disappeared after the fog lifted.
So let's get this straight. Senpai and that
dangerous, but we might be able to fight them. We might save people.
Are you saying if anyone else gets thrown in here, we can save them before they disappear? Like how you guys just saved me? Anyways, we need to catch the one who's throwing people in here and make him stop. Yeah. I'm finally starting to understand what's going on.
Can I ask something too? If shadows are born from humans, what was Teddy born from?
You don't even know where you came from? How should we know?
I know some things, mostly about this world, but I don't know anything about myself. To be honest, I never thought about it until now.
Are you serious? No wonder we couldn't get a straight answer out of you.
Will you guys come back here? You'll keep your word?
Well, you're the one who said you weren't letting us out unless we do.
Oh, that's right. Okay, I'll let you out. But there's one thing. I'll be waiting for you guys here. You need to come in from the same place every time, so we can meet up. You could come in from somewhere else, but then you won't end up here. You might show up somewhere I couldn't get to you. Then you'd be doomed. Got it?
Well, pretty much. All right, can you show us the way out?
Roger that. One exit coming right up.
Cool. First, we need to make sure there aren't any employees milling around out there.
Okay, go, go, go! Squish! Hey, stop squeezing, you little...
sort of been our fault. Maybe we did go a little too far. Let's apologize to her tomorrow. I'm completely wiped out. I'm gonna go home, soak in the shower for a while, and get some sleep. I think I'm gonna sleep well tonight. Well, see you in the morning.
I'm probably gonna end it here because the next dungeon's in a couple of weeks, maybe a week or two. Maybe a week. I don't remember. But there's still...
Oh, are you surprised to see me dressed this way? My parents sent me out on an errand.
There's a ton left to do.
Are you getting used to your new town and school? Really? But it must be difficult moving to a place you know nothing about. I've never been out of Innova. So, I wouldn't know what it's like to transfer to a new school. Oh, are you getting along with Chie? I mean, I always leave early, so... I'm glad to hear that. Chie is very supportive, you know? It's always her who gives me the little extra cushion. We had homeroom together last year, too. And I still remember how we'd cut class sometimes. Oh, I should get going. I need to make tomorrow's arrangements with our head chef. Our inn can't function without me right now. I'll
See you at school then.
Sorry, we'll save after this. That's how I feel.
Oh, I need to do the dishes.
There, that's it. Well, thank you for stopping by. Wrong computer. Yes. Tomorrow I'm not here. My Sundays are shot from now on. So that's one day I'm definitely not gonna be able to. What else? I think that's it. Fridays should be fine. I'll just release the schedule in a bit. Friend streaming right now? No, I don't. I'll okay. Yeah, so tomorrow no stream. I'll be back Monday. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do yet though. And that's it. Little short stream just to get started. It's gonna be like another 20-parter for this. Maybe a little bit quicker than P3, but story-wise, there's a lot to unfold. Alright, I'm out of here. I'll see y'all Monday.